serious work. What time is it? It is... I think it's like 10 minutes till 7 here in Oxnard. Where are you at? What time is it where you're at? We have Alex right here, aka The Nail. We're over here at the boxing laboratory. Wow, what are you doing up at 3 a.m.? Hey, that's good, you're tuning in to ESNEWS. Here's the coach, head coach. How you doing, head coach?
I'm all right.
Doing all right. He's been walking around with this, like, whip. What is that?
If they misbehave.
Head coach over here, boxing laboratory. If they misbehave, they get smacked. Donald doesn't train here. Where is Donald? Somebody just asked.
He's helping Brandon at another gym.
Okay, so he's helping Brandon at another gym, and he'll go to RGB in Riverside. Thank you. There's your answer. Okay, so Alex's record one more time. I'm sorry. I'm
14-0.
Alex, aka The Nail. 14-0. 12 knockouts. Yes, I believe, you know, obviously this gym along with RGBAs, they're all hoping that Brandon Rios wins this fight as well.
Funny, this guy comes on Tuesday, don't he?
You come on my day, huh?
Yeah, he was here last Tuesday, right?
He was.
I haven't seen him ever since.
Wait, are you stalking me? I'm just joking. Robert Garcia's wife is the best. Somebody just showed up at RGBA, right? And she and I happened to be out in the front. And this guy, she thought he knew me and I thought he knew her. And so we're just kind of like standing there and like, he's like, hey, I'm a fan. And she's like, okay. And he was like, can I come in and watch? And she was like, this is a private gym, you know? And she was like, how did you find us? And he's like, I'm a fan. And she's like, no, you're a stalker. Dude, she's so gangster. I was like, yo. Like, I mean, she was nice about it, obviously. But like, but that's true. Like, she's like, you know, like. How do you guys feel about people coming? This is a closed gym, right?
Yeah, right.
Yeah, people aren't allowed just to come. And Robert, you know, like, was nice and said hi and all that stuff.
Yeah, no, when somebody comes here looking for them, I don't give them the address. I just give them the pizza number. You can call him.
You give them pizza's number?
Yeah, reach out and reveal. It's going to be up to them if they want
to
reveal the address or have them come over. It's up to them.
Oh, no, I get so many DMs with boxers not hitting on me, but asking if they could come train at the gym. And I'm like, no, like, I can't give that authority.
Just put the address up, the address. Just make up a public workout.
The purse. I'm telling you, that's why I tell Ellie. I'm like, Marco kicks me down with all like the insight, the knowledge.
How do you feel about these guys in front? Half naked, rubbing each other for first.
Wait.
They fight for a first.
That just sounded so bad. You made me snort. You just said two guys in trunks rubbing half naked fighting.
That's what boxers do.
Fighting for a purse.
Huh?
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Alex, what do you win in a fight? What do you win in a fight? A purse, right?
In his next fight, do you think he'll be the main event? Not yet.
I don't know. Like I said, it all depends on where the purse or who wins the right to the fight.
So it's open. Anyone could go after it.
We're tentatively scheduled to fight on March 17th on the card of Jose Ramirez, Amir Guzman. They're fighting for the WC title. So we fight on that day for their co-main event.
If you don't mind me asking, what are your thoughts of the rumors going around about Amir Khan and Adrian Broner?
Okay. Broner had a decent run at welterweight until he met Maidana, but and Amir Khan's coming off a big long layoff and a brutal knockout. So Broner lost the decision to Mike, but Mike is one of the best at the moment. So both coming off losses, Broner being the more active fighter, Amir Khan moving back down to welterweight from super welterweight. It's an interesting fight. They both need a win to keep going.
Is there any any amount of neck work?
Amount of neck work?
That could legitimately strengthen someone?
Well, there's different workouts. Like some guys, two guys helping, one guy helping the other guy, you know, with their force, pushing the other hand. Like he's got a thing from Everlast with, you put a weight on the chains and strengthen the neck. There's different ways.
Do you think that's essential?
I prefer somebody helping him. Like if somebody helping you with the towel or just putting pressure on one side, that'll strengthen the neck. But sometimes there's nobody to help you, so you gotta do it on your own.
Somebody wants to know, why does he put the weights down in between rounds? Just switch it up.
Not in between rounds. What he's doing right now is doing the 1 minute intervals. 1 minute with the weights, 1 minute with the weights.
Gotcha.
And rest in 30 seconds.